Hello guys and girls, and it's great to see you today again. This is Penelope, my penguin, and she wanted to join us as we learnt this verse from the Bible. This is a Bible verse which can be found in your Bible in the New Testament and in John, which is Matthew, Mark, Luke and John, chapter 14 and verse 6. And I'm just going to read it to you from my Bible. Said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So, that is Jesus speaking, and he is speaking to Thomas, and he was telling him this, because Thomas had asked him, Lord, we do not know where you're going, and how can we know the way? This is Jesus answering him. Now, boys and girls, we are going to have a look at this verse, but before we go any further, I was wondering, would you like to take a wee run through reading it? So, we're going to start after 3. 1, 2, 3. The Bible says in John chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Yes, Penelope, you did very well. Yes, there's some big words, but you did very well. I think all the boys and girls did well too, don't you? Well, I think maybe we'll do it again. And we'll do it after 3, okay? 1, 2, 3. The Bible says in John chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Now, boys and girls, as I say, this is Jesus speaking to Thomas, and he was answering Thomas's question. Thomas wanted to know where Jesus was going, and Jesus was just trying to explain to him that he was going the way that he had to go. Now, boys and girls, in this verse he is explaining that he is the way, the truth, and the life. And he is also explaining that no one comes to the Father except through him. Now, boys and girls, who can tell me who Jesus is? Yes, Penelope? Yes. God's only Son. God sent his Son down to earth and asked Jesus to come to earth to take our punishment. The punishment for our sins. And our sins are the things that we think, that we see, that we say, and that we do. And boys and girls, things we do day and daily. Because, boys and girls, we were born sinners. Who was the first sinner? Yes, Penelope. Yes, Adam and Eve. They sinned in the Garden of Eden, right the way back at the very beginning, because they disobeyed God by eating the fruit of the tree that he told them not to eat from. And since then, we have continued to sin. And God can't have sin. God is pure, and so is Jesus. Neither of them have ever sinned, and they can't have sinners in, well, God can't have sinners in his presence. And so he asked Jesus to come down to earth and to take our punishment. So Jesus died on the cross to save us from our sin. My boys and girls, let's have a look at the next slide. Jesus said he was the way, truth, and life. And the first picture we have is of a two-way road. Maybe, boys and girls, you have somewhere like this on your road. Maybe not far from your house. Maybe somewhere you go for a walk. And you have a choice to make. You either go one way or the other. There's no other options. Yes, I know you could walk through the middle of the trees, but it's not technically the right way to go. So you have a choice to make, and that's the same with God. There's a choice to make. We can either follow God, or we can either go our own way. Nice, boys and girls. The next picture. It's another choice, or another set of directions. There's the truth, or there's lying. If we go by God's way, we're going the way of truth. because Jesus and God are telling us the truth. We're born sinners, we have sinned, we will sin, but that Jesus came to set us free from our sin, so that we can be with our Father God. But the devil has his eyes, and he takes us down the wrong way. Now boys and girls, there's only two ways. There is only a choice of one or the other. There isn't a middle road. There is no fence to sit on. There is no anywhere else to go. There is only to God or not to God. And then we have life. And that means that Jesus gives us new life. Life with a purpose. And in the shorter catechism, it tells us or asks us, what is our chief end? And that means, what is the main purpose of man? Why? What is our purpose? And it tells us that our chief end is to glorify God and to enjoy Him forever. So what our role in this world is to give God all the glory and to enjoy Him forever. So when we come to Jesus and we confess our sins, He will cleanse us of our sins so that we can be with God. And then we will live a life glorifying Him and enjoying Him. Now, who can tell me what sins are? Give me an example of a sin. Oh, when you nip Pip, Pip didn't mean to, you know, nip you. And you really shouldn't have nipped him back. He shouldn't have nipped you, but you shouldn't have nipped him back. What about when I ask you to do something and I find out later you haven't done it? Oh, you've forgotten. Not so sure that's exactly what happened, but okay. So, there's lots of things. There's maybe we borrow something from our friend, but we don't give it back. We keep it. That's stealing. Maybe we see something our friends are wearing and we want them. We want the very same as what they have. That is being jealous. That is coveting something that's not ours. So there's lots and lots of things. Lots of things. And they come either through the words that we say, the things that we think, the things that we do. Oh, they come in every direction. But if we come to Jesus, He will help us. Okay, want to give this Bible verse another go? Alright, we'll do that for three. 1, 2, 3. The Bible says in John chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Well done. That's excellent. Oh, there's a picture and it's popped up over some of the words. Uh-oh, another picture. What is it? Oh, it's a signpost. Yes, two ways. Only two ways. Either God's way or our way. Ah, there's the cross. To remind us that Jesus died for us so that we might follow God's way for our lives. Okay, who wants to give us a plan? Yes, yes, okay, Penelope. I'll help you. Are you ready after three? 1, 2, 3. The Bible says in John chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. That is really well done. I am delighted. Well done. Now, there's another part of the verse. No one comes to the Father except through me. Yes, that's through Jesus. You see, boys and girls, there's like a brick wall keeping us from getting near to God. And that is our sins. They are blocking our way to Jesus. But Jesus came down into this world, born as a baby, grew up, and gave His life on the cross for us. He suffered on that cross for us. And then He rose again 3 days after. We're soon be celebrating that at Easter. So that through Him, we can now get to the Father, who is God in heaven. That is amazing, isn't it, boys and girls? But we can get rid of the sin through Jesus. We're back at our verse again. Look at that. What's that? A cross? The road. Oh, the signpost. Yes, the first decision. Which way to go? The man. Us, you and me. We have to make that decision. Okay, who wants to give it a go? I'm seeing if we can remember their verse. Are you ready to help us? We're going to go after this. 1, 2, 3. The Bible says in John chapter 14 verse 6, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Well done. That was good. Oh, there's another. Oh, covered more words. Do you think, are we up to a challenge? I think we are. Will we go again after three? 1, 2, 3. The Bible says in John chapter 14 verse 6, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Well, that's brilliant, boys and girls. You have done a really good job at learning with us today. Would you think so, can I be? Yes. Now, please, I want you to say goodbye to all the boys and girls because you have to go now, yes, yes. Say goodbye, no, goodbye. Oh, that's it, really. Goodbye, you see you later. Thank you. Well done.